Given f of x equals g of x divided by h of x, we want to use the graphs provided to determine f prime of 5. We'll notice first that function f is a quotient of two functions, so we'll first find the derivative function using the quotient rule provided here below. Then we'll come back and analyze the graph to determine f prime of 5. So we'll come back to these graphs in just a moment. Reviewing the quotient rule, if we want the derivative of function f divided by function g with respect to x, this derivative would be equal to g times f prime minus f times g prime divided by g squared. Again, where f is in the numerator and g is in the denominator. So we have to be a little careful here because our variables are different. Our numerator is g of x, and our denominator is h of x. So it might be more helpful to think of this as the denominator times the derivative of the numerator minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator divided by the denominator squared. So in our case, f prime of x is going to be equal to a quotient. But notice how the denominator is just the denominator squared, so we would have h of x squared. And the numerator is the denominator times the derivative of the numerator, which would be h of x times g prime of x, and then minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator. So we'd have g of x times h prime of x. But our goal is to find f prime of 5, so now we'll substitute 5 for x. So we'll have h of 5 times g prime of 5 minus g of 5 times h prime of 5 divided by h of 5 squared. Let's go ahead and take this derivative function value to the previous slide and analyze the graphs. Again, here's the graph of function g of x, and here's the graph of function h of x. Notice how we need to find g of 5 and g prime of 5, where g prime of 5 would be the slope of the tangent line at x equals 5. We also have to find h of 5 and h prime of 5, where h prime of 5 would be the slope of the tangent line at x equals 5 for h of x. Let's begin by determining the function values g of 5 and h of 5, and then we'll talk about how we're going to find these derivative function values. So we evaluate g of 5, we want to find the function value or y value when x equals 5. Here's where x equals 5. Notice how the function value would be 4. And then for h of 5, here's where x equals 5. Notice how the function value is 3. Now let's discuss how we're going to find these derivative function values. Again, g prime of 5 is equal to the slope of the tangent line at x equals 5. So here's the point where x equals 5. And notice how if we sketch a tangent line to our function, because it's linear, the tangent line will contain the graph of the function. The graph of the tangent line would look like this. So because our function is linear, and the tangent line contains the function, we can use the graph to determine the slope of this tangent line and therefore find g prime of 5. So if we select this point here that's also on the tangent line, notice how the change of y is positive 1 because we go up 1, and the change of x is positive 2 because we go right 2 to go from this point to this point. And since the slope of the tangent line is 1/2 at x equals 5, g prime of 5 is 1/2. Now taking a look at function h, if we sketch a tangent line at x equals 5, it would look like this, containing the right piece of the function. And therefore, once again, we can select two points on this tangent line to determine the slope and therefore find h prime of 5. So if we use this point at x equals 5 and this point at x equals 4, notice how we'd have to go down 1 unit and right 1 unit. So the change of y is negative 1 and the change of x is positive 1. And therefore the slope of the tangent line is negative 1 at x equals 5. and therefore h prime of 5 is negative 1. And now we just need to perform substitution into our function value here, which should be not just f prime of x, but f prime of 5. So let's go ahead and do that. The denominator would be h of 5 squared, where h of 5 is 3, so we'd have 3 squared. Looking at the numerator, we have h of 5, which we know is 3, times g prime of 5, which is 1 half, and then minus g of 5, which is 4, times h prime of 5, which is negative 1. So we have 3 halves plus 4, so I'm going to write plus 4 over 1, and then we're going to divide this by 9. If we obtain a common denominator here, that would be 2, so we multiply by 2 over 2. So this is equal to 3 halves plus 8 halves, that would be 11 halves. And instead of dividing by 9, we can multiply by the reciprocal. The reciprocal of 9 is 1/9, so we have times 1/9, and therefore h prime of 5 is equal to 11/18. I hope you found this helpful.